So my brother carved the arms into kind of snake figures, and we put a yoke across here. Instead of actually tying the yoke to the arms like they did in the prehistoric period and gluing it, we've actually got a screw going through there. It gives us a little bit more stability because this thing is going to go on the road with us some. I've got half-inch holes through the yoke. And then these are half-inch dowels going into those for tuning rods. We've rosined them up to make them not so loose. And I've used nylon classical guitar strings for the strings. Originally, of course, it was catgut, which really was cow or deer or beef intestine. At the bottom, I've also got a dowel made from the same dowel as the yoke. That's a 1-inch dowel, and I've screwed it to the arms on the other side, the bottom side of the gourd, and run 1/8-inch holes through it for the strings. These are tied in classical knots. Plenty of videos on YouTube to show how to tie the classical knot. These tuning pegs also have the 1/8-inch holes in them, not only for the strings, but at the tip of them, they have them for tuning pins. You can take a nail or whatnot, and it makes it a lot easier to tune those rods. That's not quite the Niatiti style or the Babylonian style of tuning, although the Babylonian style of tuning looks like this. They actually did it in one of two ways. The Niatiti, the string actually goes around the yoke, and they put a string, a dowel at the end of it just to help you turn it and twist it. Whereas the Babylonian style, they actually had rods tied to the top of the yoke, and they'd round the string around that, and they would turn in separate, the string that tied them to the yoke, which was separate from the actual musical string. And the reason I think they did this is because they had probably started out with a design more like this, but it's harder to make holes through a piece of metal. And the Babylonian lyres that have made it down to us are all made of metal, not wood. Their prototype, their wooden prototype that they were working from, was probably a lot more than like this, and that's why we've made our prehistoric lyre in such a way. There you have it, a proto-Niatiti or prehistoric lyre. It's a basic design of a Niatiti from Africa in that it's made from a gourd and wood. And it has a sound that's probably a little bit more like the Babylonian lyres, because instead of having a skin stretched across it like a drum, it has a hole in the resonating chamber. That's how the earliest lyres that we know of were done. And this instrument dates from sometime around 4000 BC to as much as 8000 BC. The gourd made its way from Southeast Asia all the way to Africa about that time. Well, I really appreciate you guys coming by and hanging out. I got a lot more instructionals on ancient instruments to show you in the weeks to come. They're all being made for the soundtrack of my prehistoric fiction stories. And the first one will be coming out in December of this year. It's called The Lords, The Boy, and The Dragon. Two of the stories in this series have won awards from Writers of the Future competition, and we're going to have artwork to go along with them too. The second two in the series will be coming out on Radiant Crown Publishing and on Immortal Works Press in 2018. So I'm really excited to bring you the prequel to both of those and the music I've been making. You've already heard some of it here. Doing some ambient music from the first soundtrack. So please subscribe, like it, and hope to see you next week.